Okay, we broke off Isaiah chapter 6 with his commission. He has seen God. He has seen these creatures called seraphim. He has pronounced his sin. He has been clean, not of blood, but of fire. God reaches out and says, okay, who's going to go for me? He's like, I am. Go, send me. That's where we stop. And he said, go. That's what the Christians do. Go. Go ye in all the world and preach the gospel. He said, go and tell this people, Jews, Jerusalem, hear ye indeed. Tell them to listen. But understand not. He's going to tell them the judgment of God, and they're not going to know. And see indeed, look, but perceive not. It's kind of odd. Go tell the people to listen, 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 but they're not going to be able to comprehend what they heard. See. They're going to see it, but they're not going to get it. Make the heart of this people fat. Cholesterol. Death. Hardened arteries. Make their eyes heavy. Sleepy. And shut their eyes. Closed, blind, least they see with their eyes. They've gotten so far into their sin. God says, I want you to pronounce a judgment against them. But they're not going to listen. They're not going to hear. That's how hard off they are. And hear with their ears. I don't want them to know. They're going to listen, but they're not going to get it. And understand with their heart and convert and be healed. This is Isaiah. This is what he is told to do. I want you to go to a bunch of people. They're going to hear you. They're going to see you. But they ain't going to do nothing. Acts 28:25 and John 12:38. That's how they were in Jesus' time. Man, they heard him, they listened to him, they followed him, but they nailed him to a cross. Would have been something else if they would say, Jesus, the scripture says that you're to die, you're to suffer. Explain that to us. Tell us what to do and tell us what you're going to do that we may. And they never did. And they knew who Jesus was. They had knowledge of the scriptures. They just didn't. Then said I, Isaiah speaks of, Lord, how long? That's a kind of weird commission for Isaiah. How long do you want me to do this, Lord? How long do you want me to speak to people who are not going to listen and show these people that they're not going to watch? Isaiah's going to walk a period of time of nakedness as a sign to Israel. They see him. They don't listen. They don't take heed. They don't get right. And he, God, answered, unto the cities be wasted without inhabitant. And the houses without man. And the land be utterly desolate. Captivity. Dude, they're gone. Dude, they're gone to Babylon. Imagine somebody coming up to you and say, hey, you go to this restaurant and you get yourself a free meal. Everything you want, free. There it is. Buffet, whatever you want, seafood, steakhouse, chicken legs, whatever you want, whatever you like. There it is, it's all yours. All right, there it is, I want that, Lord. But after that, you're going to puke, you're going to get sick. You're... Lord, how long? What kind of illustration is that? For people not to go in that restaurant at that time because there's sickness in the food, the place is unclean, whatever. I want you to be the illustration of those people not to go in that place because they're going to get sick. And you get out there and you're vomiting and, oh man, your stomach is in pain and you call 911, the ambulance comes. As soon as they cart you off, they go in there and start eating. The same stuff that you ate. And they end up dead. You end up in the hospital getting stomach pump or whatever they do for it. They end up dead. And carried to the graveyard. And the Lord has removed men far away. And there be a great forsaking in the midst of the land. They took Jeremiah and Baruch and went down, stole Jeremiah and Baruch down into Egypt. 3 times Nebuchadnezzar comes to this land and brings few back, then brings it all back. You mean they didn't get the point the first time Nebuchadnezzar came? They didn't get it the second time? The third time the psalm says, and we hanged our harps upon the whittles. Sing us a song. How can we sing a song in a strange land? Why didn't you listen to Isaiah? Why didn't you listen to Jeremiah? But yet, in it, the land, verse 12, shall be a tenth. That's a tithe. And it shall return. Coming back. And shall be eaten. Uh-oh. Cannibalism. Now a lot more than a tenth came back in a Babylon captivity. We're given the numbers in Ezra and Nehemiah. And when they came back, they weren't eaten. As a teal tree. So what's a teal tree? It's a tree that can be eaten. And as an oak, whose substance is in them. The food, the light. When they cast their leaves, fall. So the holy seed, Israel, shall be the substance thereof. No. The Antichrist is going to kill him. And that golden cup of the woman that's sitting on the beast is going to drink the blood of the saints. In our Lord's Supper, in our church, a Bible-founded, foundation, biblical church, we drink grape juice. outside of the fact of going to the store and getting grapes and putting them into a juicer, getting the freshest grape we get, the new wine. That's what we drink. And we drink it as a symbol of the blood of Christ, not the blood of Christ. Now let me get this. As we do verse 13, chapter 6. Two interesting numbers. There is a church out there, and churches. One church, it's not the little blood of Christ, but it's as close as you can get. There's a church out there, you bless the hooch, because it's hooch, and it becomes the literal, actual, and you ask them, they'll swear to it up and down and all around, that in that cup is the blood of a Jewish man. Well, it's the blood of Jesus. Wasn't Jesus Jewish? So when you go to Mass and you take that cup and you believe it is the blood of a Jewish man, Jesus, you are cannibalizing yourself of drinking Jewish blood from a man. Now, don't you find it interesting in the Bible when you read, it said in the law, thou shalt not eat the blood. Blood is a liquid. Eating flesh of a human is cannibalism. It is forbidden before the law. It is forbidden during the law, and it is forbidden under grace in the church age. It is forbidden in the tribulation, because the tribulation, the law is back. It is forbidden under the millennium, because you're under the law. What is the Antichrist going to be doing? He's going to be drinking the literal, with no magic trick, he's going to be slaying Jews and taking their blood, and they're going to be taking their blood for drink offerings. Beheading them. Going against the Bible. Killing God's holy seed. And Isaiah warns them. Yet Jews today in 2015 are not listening. They're not giving heed. America today, there are some people who do listen. There are some people who will get saved. Jeremiah, you can't find one convert at all. Later on, Daniel, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, reading Jeremiah, they get right. But while Jeremiah was living, while they are in the land, not one person was a convert to Jeremiah. See how many converts we get with Isaiah as we continue on 60 more chapters. Let's count along with it. How many people actually come to Isaiah and say, hey, I want to get right. I don't want to be blind. I won't want ears that are deaf. I want to see and I want to hear what God has to say. Let's take Mark now as we go into this book. I wonder how many. Not going to be many. For many going away in the broad way, going away the path that leads to destruction, and few that find the straight gate. There wasn't even a few in Jeremiah's time. There was none. Noah had a few. Seven other people besides him. And the entire world went into hell and damnation. Lot had a few. He had three. And one fell away. The entire city of Sodom and Gomorrah and the neighboring cities thereof had judgment and died and went into hell. Strong commission. God knows already they're not going to take heed, and God in his mercy and his grace is judging them by telling them what he's going to do in grace and mercy and long suffering before he does the final judgment. He warns them. Oh, God's so wicked, why did he kill? No, God is not so wicked, why did he kill his baby? God has warned you over and over and over and over. You just didn't want to hear, and you didn't want to see. You didn't want to perceive. You didn't want to look. It was there. Every person in the world that rejects God has an Isaiah in their life. Somewhere, sometime, an Isaiah. Somewhere, in someone's time that has rejected Jesus Christ, they have had a Paul planting. They have had a Apollos watering. It's out there. How many years in America? How many years? How many generations around December had, they don't do it no more. It's done. But how many years and generations has there been when you've gone to the stores and you've heard the Christmas carol about a baby being born in a manger, being God's son?
I never knew. I didn't know nothing.
Away in a manger. What about that one? Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn king. I didn't know. What about that? You heard that. You used to hear that all the time in the stores. You used to hear it in the churches. The radios would play carols. At least December 25th, there was time on radio, at least one radio station that would play the carols. See, we gone. You heard them, but you just ignored them. Now they're totally gone. Send me. All right, I'll send you. But guess what? They're not going to listen to you. So God already tells Isaiah in the beginning, guess what? Don't expect results. How's that one? Your modern church today wouldn't even believe that one. They wouldn't do it. They'd turn around and tell God, no. There's no results. I won't do it. I said, okay, let's go.